Hello, little girls, maybe the boys, maybe the dog. Who knows who's even listening to these things anymore? I got a new book, Children Around the World. So it'll probably tell us a little bit about what children do and like in other countries, on other places around the world. Because we live in just one little spot in the world, the United States. The state of Nebraska, the city of Omaha, and this will tell us about other places. We live somewhere in the middle of this country right here, the United States, but there's lots of other countries to choose from, so let's read about a few of them, see what we learn. Children around the world, a world full of children, it says. A lot of good things to see here. I still can't get you far enough away. And then maybe I get you too far away and you can't even see it. A world full of children. The world is very big. It is filled with children. There are children with black hair, blonde hair, red hair, and brown hair. There are children with dark skin, light skin, and colors in between. Children wear clothes of many colors. Green overalls, yellow dresses, purple running shoes, and blue sweaters with stars. In Tibet, young Buddhist monks wear red robes. In Mongolia, children tie yellow sashes around their waists. Maasai girls of Africa have necklaces made of tiny colored beads. Children everywhere have families and friends they like to play and go to school, just like you. Oh, here's a bunch of children that live all over the place. You have Miguel in Mexico, and Adam in Canada, and Tim in the United States, and Rosa in Bolivia, and Fatima in Morocco, and Stavros in Greece, and Deepa in India, and Ming Chan in China, Sadako in Japan, Emilio in the Philippines, Malika in Tanzania, and Kathy in Australia. Come and meet these children from around the world. Hi, I'm Emilio from the Philippines. My country is made up of islands, 7,000 of them. Holy cow, it's a lot. My island is the most beautiful of all. It is never cold here, but summer is a rainy season. It rains for 3 months. My mother and father have a rice farm. Growing rice is a lot of work. We eat rice every day. My father catches fish in the ocean. Sometimes I help him fish. But during the week, I go to school. I have a little pet chicken. His name is Pepe. I hope he won't end up in the cooking pot like the other chickens. So they grow rice and they raise chickens. And they eat the chickens. Because that's what you do. You farm chickens and then you eat them. Hi, I'm Malika from Tanzania. I live in Tanzania in East Africa. It is always hot here in my village. I speak Swahili at home. I like to wear colorful clothes. I wear my best clothes on Sundays when I go to church. My father works in the big city. When he is away, he sends us letters. I read them with my mother and sister. It feels as if he is here with us. In our school, big children and little children all learn together. We are studying English. I know my ABCs already. Sometimes my older sister does my hair in tiny braids with beads on the ends. Hello, I'm Ming Chan from China. I live in Beijing. It is a very big city. Once I went to see the Great Wall. I speak Mandarin Chinese. At school, I am learning to write. We write with characters. They are a little bit like pictures. By the time I am big, I need to know thousands of characters. My mother and father ride bicycles to work. I have a bike too. I like to race with my friends. My favorite lunch is shrimp and steamed dumplings with rice. I use chopsticks to eat. My mother was born under the sign of the dragon. I was born under the sign of the tiger. That means I am very brave. Remember, we've gone to the Chinese restaurant and we found out what animal you were born under? Maybe you remember that, maybe you don't. That's from the Chinese culture. Hi, I'm Kathy from Australia. I live on a farm in New South Wales. I learned to ride a horse while I was very small. My horse's name is Dave. He is gentle and he loves carrots. My parents raise sheep. There are sheep everywhere. In Australia, we have animals you cannot find anywhere else in the world. The kangaroo, the wombat, the koala bear. Sometimes I go to town with my parents. I really like the lights and the shops, but all that noise gives me a headache. At the farm, it is always quiet. I like it here best. Hi, I'm Adam from Canada. I live way up north in Nunavut. Nunavut is a territory of Canada. The North Pole is in Nunavut. I am Inuit. Inuit means the people. In winter, it is very cold here, but my husky dog is never cold. We love to play in the snow together. I have warm things to wear, boots, gloves, a parka, a hat, a scarf. My mother buys food at the grocery store. My father likes to hunt for seals. When he is far from home, he builds an igloo to keep warm. When I am bigger, he will teach me how. I live in a house made of wood. At home, we speak Inuit. I have no idea. I'm dumb. Sorry. At school, my class is making a website. So they live way up in North America. Inuit, I think, is how it's pronounced. I don't know. Hi, I'm Tim from the United States. I live in New York City. It's full of skyscrapers. People call it the Big Apple. I like to go to the park with my friends. We play basketball and go inline skating. My parents both work in offices. They come home at 6 o'clock at night. When they are not here, Mandy stays at home with me. She's my babysitter. Mom and Dad do not want me to watch too much television, but I can play computer games. Mandy fixes my snacks, a peanut butter sandwich. I live on the 31st floor of my building. It feels like the top of the world. I can see the whole city from the window. Holy cow. That's way up in the sky. Hello, I'm Deepa from India. My city is called Varanasi. The Ganges River runs through it. My family is Hindu. To us, the Ganges River is sacred. Many, many people come to visit Varanasi. They bathe in the river and visit temples. I live in a brick house by the river. My mother makes delicious meals for me and my brother. My favorite is curried vegetables and a flatbread called chapati. My mother is a weaver. When I am not in school, I help sell her fabrics to the market. Women buy them to make dresses called saris. When I am big, I want to be a weaver too. Hi, I'm Miguel from Mexico. I live in Mexico City, and I speak Spanish. It is mostly sunny and warm here. I like to visit the market on Saturdays. They sell ponchos and a lot of hot chilies. When I come home from school, I eat my lunch. My mother makes tortillas with cheese, beans, and spicy sauce called salsa. My father is a dentist. He eats with us too. After lunch, he takes a siesta. You know what a siesta is? You said nap, you're right. It's a nap. Last summer, we went to the ocean. We saw tourists from all over the world. I love swimming with the fish. Ooh, Dad got to go swimming with the fish recently. I'll show you pictures when I get home. Hi, I'm Sadako from Japan. Japan is a country made up of islands. I live in the city of Osaka. It is on the big island in the middle. I eat with chopsticks. My favorite food is raw fish. It is called sushi when it is rolled with rice, and sashimi when it is only fish. Yummy. I sleep on a mattress called a futon. At night, I unroll it on the floor. In the morning, I roll it up and put it away. My mother wears pants and sweaters, but my grandmother wears kimonos. She gave me one for my birthday. I like video games and comic books. In Japanese, comic books are called manga. Hello, I'm Stavros from Greece. I live near a village in the mountains. We keep goats on our farm. My father makes goat cheese called feta. It's delicious. Every morning I go to school, the teacher reads us stories about ancient heroes. My favorite hero is Hercules. I have one brother and two sisters. We like to watch television. We cheer for our favorite team. For a holiday, we go to the beach. My grandparents always come along. My mother packs a picnic with tomato salad and feta cheese. We play in the sand and watch the boats sail by. Hello, I'm Rosa from Bolivia. My country is in South America. I am an Amarillo Indian. I live in a village in the mountains beside Lake Titicaca. My father makes boats out of reeds. Grandfather taught him how. I want to learn too. My mother looks after our sheep and our llama. Every day she takes them up to graze. With my brother I speak Amara. In school we are learning Spanish. My aunt lives in the big city, La Paz. When she visits, we have a party. We play music and dance. More and more children. Meet Ahmed, who lives in Egypt near the pyramids, and Chinda from Thailand, who loves to dance. Here's Kari, who lives in New Zealand. From her porch, she watches dolphins in the sea. This is Helena, who lives in Poland and plays the violin. The world is very big and filled with children. Many children in many places, many things to do and many things to learn. If you want to meet more children, hop on the rainbow and fly around the world. The end. Well, I hope you enjoyed this book. Learned something about some children around the world. Took in some of their culture. Love you guys very much and hope to see you really soon. We'll see. Bye.